Hello students, how are you all? I hope you all are doing good. Children, as you all are aware that yesterday we had completed with our multiplication of money, our third basic fundamental operations on money, and today we are going to start division of money. Now, division is the fourth basic fundamental operations which we are going to use on money. So in this first thing, how to divide? Division will be done in that same way we were doing in decimals. Fine. Wherever decimal will come, that decimal will go in quotient, and that quotient will be written with the symbol of rupee. I'll repeat it again. Whenever you are doing division of money and you will get that decimal or that point will go into quotient, and after division, the quotient will be written with the symbol of rupee. So this is the basic thing which you have to keep it in your mind, and then you have to do that division of money. So children, today we will start with division only. First few questions, that is divide this amount of money by that particular number. So we'll do that division and we'll understand how we will do it. Fine. And how that decimal concept is used in this division of money also. So we'll understand that. So for doing it, we'll do question 6 of exercise 9.3. Now exercise 9.3 we already started day before yesterday, and we have finished till 5 questions, because those 5 questions were related to multiplication of money. So right now we are going to start division of money, and for doing it, first we will understand how to do divide of a given amount of money by that particular number. So for understanding that, we will do question number 6, that is of divide, and we'll understand this. Actually the concept is not new, but still you have to understand it. A, that is rupee 42 and 90 paisa divided by 3. This is your A part of the question. Now, when you are doing solution of this, first of all, how we will write when we have to do division. So we'll make this symbol and we will write down this amount, that is 42 and 90. Here that will be divided by 3. See, after division, whatever quotient we will get here now, that quotient we will write with the symbol of rupee. See how. Now 3 ones are, that will become 3. 1 will be remaining, 2 will get down. 3 fours are 12. And then this point will go into quotient. What I have told you, whenever you will get the point, that point will go into quotient. So this point goes into quotient. Now 9 will get down. 3 threes are, that will be 9. And 0 will get down last. Then 3 zeros are will be 0. So what is the quotient here? The quotient is, we'll understand this division again because it's not easy. 14.30 means rupee 14 and 30 paisa. See children, it is not necessary that you will have to do only this 2-digit decimal division. You can be getting a 3-digit, 4-digit, whatever. The method is same. See how. You have been given that rupees 42 and 90 paisa, that will be divided by 3. So what you have done, 42 and 90 paisa, that you have written in the form of division, and then you started doing division. Now 3 ones are will be 3, 1 will be remaining, 2 will get down, 3 fours are 12, nothing will be remaining. Now 9 will get down, 3 threes are 9, nothing was remaining. Now 0 will be there, 3 zeros are 0. Nothing is left now. Now quotient is what? This, rupees 14 and 30 paisa, rupees 14 and 30 paisa. So children, I hope the concept, the method, how to do division, how to do this division of rupee and paisa. So in that row only we will take next question. Again, in that also it is given B part, how to do divide. Fine. So let's do it. Now next is rupee, B part, rupee 112 and 42 paisa divided by 7. Yes, so this is the question. Now here you have to divide rupee 112 and 42 paisa by 7. So what you will do it? You will write it in the form of division and then we will start with 7. Now 1 is smaller, we are going to take 2 places, 11 we will take, 7 ones are 7. What is remaining here? 11 minus 7, 4 will be remaining, 2 will get down. Now 7, 6 are 42. What is remaining? Nothing will be remain here. Now what we got it? We got this decimal. Well, this decimal will go into the, or that point will goes into quotient. Now 4 will get down. Now you can see that this 4 is smaller than 7. So will it will goes on 0, 7 zeros are will be 0, 4 will be remaining. Now this 2 will get down. Now 7, 6 are 42. Whenever we are getting anything which is smaller, actually what happened, whenever we are getting any number which is smaller than our divisor, so what we are doing, we are putting a zero in quotient and then that next number will get down. Now why we were putting that zero, that I have explained here, like 7 zeros are, all the table was started from zeros are only. If it will not go on 1s, it will go on 0s. 7 0s will be 0. 7 0s will be 0 here. Then 42. Then 7 6s 42. Now what is the quotient here? Quotient is, what is the quotient here? Rupee 16 and 6 paisa. Rupee 16 and 6 paisa. See children, it is very important to do practice of all these divisions. That is an important part of mathematics. Practice is an important part of mathematics. Rest all the subjects you can cram, but maths cannot. Without practice, you cannot do a single question. Fine. So in this way we can do the division of a little bit bigger number also. If I'll give you 3 digit, 4 digit or either 5 digit number, then also you can do this division. So now this we will understand once again and after that we will start that next C part. Now 112 and 42 paisa, that is supposed to do division by 7. So we have written in the form of division. Now 7 ones will be 7. What will be remaining? 4 will be remaining. Now 2 will get down. 7 6 are 42. 4. Now nothing was remaining. Now we got this point. So this point will go into quotient. And then what will get down? 4 will get down. Now because 4 is smaller than 7, then what we will do? 7 zeros will be 0 here. 4 will be remaining. Now 2 will get down next. this 2. Now 7, 6 are 42. So what is the quotient here? Rupee 16.06. So children, now we will start our C part of this division. Division of money. And then we are going to take problems from our day-to-day life. See, in this you have been given with some example also. There are few word problems. And word problems, in that also you are supposed to do that division only. So first we will finish this. Rupee 1315.20, that will be divided by what? Divided by 12. So now what we will do it? We will do the division now. Like this, you must be knowing how to do division of 2 digit, 3 digit, 4 digit. As many digit you can write over there and you can do that division. That will only brings a practice in your thought that how we are supposed to do this division. So let's start that. 12 ones will be 12. Now 1 will be remaining, 1 will get down. Now you can see this 11 is smaller than this 12. Then what we are doing, that if it will not go on one's time, it can go zero's time. So we'll write this 12 zeros will be 0. What will be remaining? 11. And now here 5 will get down. 12 nines are 108. Now what is left? 7. And then we got this point. This point will goes into quotient. 2, 12, 6 are 72. Nothing was remaining. 0 will get out. 12 zeros are 0. Now what is the quotient here? Quotient is, what is the quotient here? Rupee 109.60. Rupee 109.60. Let's see this division once again. See, this division part is very important. If you will not do this division properly, then you will be having problem later. Now 12 ones will be 12. 1 will be remaining, then 1 will get down. Zeros will be 0. Why we have done this zeros? Because 11 is smaller than 12. So it will not goes on once. So it will goes on 0 times. So that will become 11 will be remaining. 5 will get down. 12 nines are 108. 7 will be remaining. 2 will get down. 12 6 are 72. Nothing was remaining. 0 will get down. 12 zeros are 0. Now what is the quotient over here? That is rupee 109.60. Fine. So children, let's move to our question number 7, which is a word problem that is related to division. So first of all, we will understand what are the key words which will help us to find it out that we are supposed to do division or supposed to do which operation we will use in that particular question. So we'll start with this question number 7. Now what is given here? Question number 7. The cost of 6 books is rupees 1277.40. Find the cost of 1 book. Quite simple question. The concept is very much clear. Whenever cost of many thing will be given and you are supposed to find it out cost of one thing, you are supposed to do division. Hear it carefully. When cost of many things will be given to you and you have to find it out, cost of one thing, then what you will do it? You will do it division. So now cost of six books. Cost of six books. First statement will be cost of six books. Now cost of six books is ₹1,277.40. Now what next? Cost of one book which you are supposed to find it out. Cost of one book. Now cost of six books is given to you and you are supposed to find it out, cost of one book. So let's start that. What you will do? Division. In this way you will write it and then that will be divided by 6. Fine. Now let's start the division here. 6 twos are 12. What is remaining? Nothing. 7 will get down. Again 6 ones are 6. 1 will be remaining. What will get down? 7. 6 twos are 12. 5 will be remaining. Now we got this point. Now what we will do it with this point? This point will go into quotient. Then 4 will get down. 6 nines are 54. Nothing will be remaining. 0 will get down. 6 zeros are will be 0. Fine. Now what is the answer here? What is the cost of one book? Therefore, cost of one book is rupee 212.90. So what we have seen in this question? In this question you have been given with cost of six books. See, in your daily life also you will find it out these kind of a problem. For example, if I will ask that cost of 100 chocolate is 500 rupees, what will be the cost of one chocolate? So what you will do, this 500 will be divided by 100 and you will be getting the cost of one chocolate, that is 5 rupees. So all these kind of a question will be there in your daily life also. So from there only we have taken the book. The publisher has taken this question, cost of six books is given, that is rupee 1,277.40. And you are supposed to find it out, cost of one book. So what you will do? You will divide this 1,277.40, that is 40 paisa, that will be divided by 6. Now very important part of the question is the division. So you will do practice a lot, take examples of this exercise and do practice a lot. Here also what we have written, cost of six book, that is 1,277.40. Cost of one book, this 1,277.40, that will be divided by 6. Start the division. 6 twos are will be 12. Then 7 6 ones are 6, 1 will be remaining, 7 will get down, 6 twos are 12, 5 will be remaining, 54, 6 nines are 54, and then 0, 6 zeros are will be 0. And here you have got the answer. Therefore, cost of one book is rupees 212.90. So children, let's take next question of division only. Now, next question 8 is, Alok paid rupees 2,029.05 for 9 chairs. How much did he pay for a chair? Now, as you can see in this question also, you have been given a cost of 9 chairs. That how much money paid by Alok? Question number 8, how much money paid by Alok for 9 chairs? That is rupees 2,029.05 for 9 chairs. How much did he pay for a chair? How much did he pay for a chair? So now here cost of 9 chairs have been given. Cost of 9 chairs have been given. Now what is the cost of 9 chairs? That is rupee 2,029.05. So this is the cost of 9 chairs. Now later on what you are supposed to find it out? Cost of 1 chair you have to find it out. Cost of 1 chair. What you will do, this 2,029.05 that will be divided by 9. That will be divided by 9. 2,029.05 that will be divided by 9 to find the cost of 1 chair. Actually, what is given in the question, that Alok paid this much money, that is rupees 2,029.05 for 9 chairs. You are supposed to find it out cost of 1 chair. So that you have find it out, cost of 1 chair 2,029.05, that will be divided by 9. So we'll start the division. 9 2s are 18. 2 will be remaining here. 2 will get down. Again 9 2s are 18. 4 will be remaining. 9 will get down. 9 5s are 45. 4 will be remaining. And now we have got this point. So this point will go into quotient. 0 will get down. 9 4s are 36. What will be remaining? 4. What will get down? 5. 9 5s are 45. So now what is the cost of 1 chair? Therefore, cost of 1 chair is rupees 225.45. This will be the cost of 1 chair. Cost of 1 chair is rupees 225.45. 225.45. Fine. So now, what next? Again, we have this word problem. Let's see this word problem once again. You have been given with Alok paid rupees 2,029.05 for 9 chairs. How much did he pay for a chair? You have to find it out that how much he paid for a chair. So what we will do, we will write cost of 9 chairs, that is 2,029.05. Cost of 1 chair you are supposed to find it out. What we will do, 2,029.05, that will be divided by 9. And then you will be getting this 225.45. Do the division here. And then you will get the answer. How we have done? 9 2s are will be 18. 2 will be remaining. 2 will get down. 9 2s are 18. 4 will be remaining. 9 will get down. 9 5s are 45. 4 will be remaining. Now we got this point. Point will goes into quotient. that quotient is basically the answer of or the cost of one item, fine, and that you have to write it with the symbol of rupee. Whenever you are writing answer of a money, this rupee symbol must be there, fine. That you always remember that whenever you are writing any answer in rupee or any answer in money, that rupee symbol must be there. And this point signifies that this amount is rupee and this amount is paisa. See, in the same way I'll spell it out also, or I'll read it out also, that rupees 225 or 225 rupees and 45 paisa. So this will be the cost of one chair. This will be the cost of one chair. So similarly, we'll do the next question. Question number 9. Now 8 pens cost rupees this much. John wants to buy one such pen. How much money does he need? Again, the question is of same kind. Question number 9. Cost of 8 pens have been given and John wants to buy one pen of such kind. And then you will do the division and you will tell what is the cost of one pen. So let's start that. Question number 9. Cost of 8 pens have been given and John wants to buy one pen. So how much money he needs to pay? That is, cost of 8 pens is rupees 522 and 40 paise. 522 and 40 paise. And cost of one pen you are supposed to find it out. Then what we will do? We'll do the division. 522 and 40 paise, that will be divided by 8. 522 that and 40 paise, that will be divided by 8. Now 8 sixa will be 48. 4 will be remaining, 2 will get down. Now 8 fivesa will be 40. 2 will be remaining. Now we got this point. So what happened? This point will goes into quotient. 4 will get down. 8 threes are 24. And then we have this 0. Then 8 zeros are will be 0. And nothing was remaining. Now here the cost of one pen. Therefore, cost of one pen is rupees 65 and 30 paise. 65 and 30 paise. So what we have done in this question? In this question you have been given with cost of 8 pens. And that cost of 8 pens will be given to you, that is rupees 522 and 40 paise. And then you have to find it out cost of one pen. So this 522 and 40 paisa, that will be divided by 8. Done the division. And then you will get the answer as a quotient, that is cost of one pen is rupees 65 and 30 paisa. Similarly, you have your 10th question also, that cost of 15 school bags will be given. And how much money did he pay if he nil bought only one bag? Now cost of 15 bags will be given. And if Anil bought only one bag, then how much money he has to pay? So that you will do it yourself. Now we have life skills. And an activity that is related to life skills, that we will do it. And challenges question, and after that we have chapter test. So tomorrow we will continue from here only. Today we will finish our class here. That's all for today, children. Fine. And the question number 10 will be your homework that you will remember. And have a good day, children.